Good morning, everyone. We are recommending The Last Kingdom. I'm actually going to be recommending two shows based on similar timelines, similar histories. Last Kingdom is a series produced by the BBC, and it got to series two, and then Netflix picked it up for series three. We are going into season four. I hope it's not delayed. I hope they already finished filming. I really do. Anyway, Last Kingdom, I highly recommend it. It's an engaging historical fiction. It is historically fictional because we don't know what actually happened. And we do have a lot of writings of that time. But it takes place during the rise of Alfred the Great. And it takes a character called Uhtred of Bernburg, who did exist. He was called Uhtred the Bold. But he existed later in history. So the author of the books basically moved him back a little bit to put him into this era of, you know, Alfred the Great. Because Alfred did so many great, amazing things. I mean, that's why he's known as Alfred the Great. And it is a fascinating look at that time. And very, very point on for historical accuracy. They don't pull punches. It's not all pretty and everybody's got beautiful clothing. It's what it was at that time. So it's based, like I said, the story revolves around Uhtred of Bernburg. Now, Uhtred of Bernburg is a Saxon. He is from Northumbria. He was born and raised there until the Viking raid came. When the Vikings came, they defeated them, and Uhtred was captured, made a slave, and then Ragnar, the person who took him as a slave, made him his son. He adopted him. Now, Ragnar, I don't know if this is Ragnar Lothbrok, or Lodbrok, or any of, there's several different Ragnars are out there. So The Last Kingdom, I would highly, highly recommend. It is, I'm not gonna say for the faint heart. You're not gonna see a lot of blood, guts, and stuff. It's pretty sanitized, but you will see the grittiness of the shield wall, which is this. Shield wall is just seeing what happens during a battle with a shield wall. They don't pull their punches. They go whole hog and show you what it's like. I will tell you right now, don't get attached to characters. Some characters will make it, some won't. Some characters are historically, you know, major players. And they're known from writings and stuff. So, again, it's something I'm going to say, it's fairly accurate. And you've got three seasons to play with. You've got a grand total of 26 episodes to watch. About 45 to an hour long each. And it does take place in the early 9th century, which is the 1000s. So within 60 years, William the Conqueror is going to be coming there. So it's incredible. I'm sitting here going, when did Easter know when Alfred the Great? Oh, geez. I can't believe I've forgotten. Aethelred was Alfred's father. King of Wessex. And that was, no, wait a minute. Yeah, it's an interest. It takes place during the reign of Alfred the Great. I'm doing the whole, I gotta check this. Alfred the Great. Alfred It was King of Wessex from 871 to 886. So, okay. So it says 9th century. So 9th century. Okay, yeah. I sometimes get my centuries confused now. So, yeah. So it's not that far removed from the raid on Lyndon's farm. So it is during that great influx of Scandinavians that are coming, searching for farming lands, lands to settle. And at that time, basically England was controlled by Scandinavians, which were known as Danes. And the English people were Saxons. And then in 1060, a descendant of Rollo the Viking, William the Conqueror, then comes across in 1060, and then it's Anglo-Saxons versus Normans. So it is a very turbulent era of time, and they depict it quite well. And they definitely portray the machinations behind the scenes with stuff that goes on and the things that Alfred does. And it's just, it's great, and I highly, highly recommend it. Now, the other series I'm going to definitely recommend, because it's pure entertainment. I love the show. Historically accurate? No. But we are going to go on to Vikings. And the same basic idea. The Vikings is based on the story of Ragnar Lothbrok and his sagas. And we know he exists because of his sons. And this covers the stories of him and his sons. And it's gone for, good lord, 6 seasons. And I believe we're in season 6 right now, and this is the last season. Now, the interesting thing is you got to realize, they show that Ragnar, the first couple of seasons are fantastic. I absolutely love them. Now, historically accurate? No, the ships are not the right size ships. The ships are Knorrs, and they're not Viking longships. That is a major, for me, it just always grates on my nerves, inaccuracy. Okay, so anyway, it is highly entertaining, and I will give it that. And that is what the writer of the series, Michael Hirst, is good at. He is good at taking a bit of history and making it interesting, so then people will get interested and they'll actually go look it up and read about the real people. Now, the interesting thing is you have Ragnar, and we know he existed. I'm not sure if he went on the Lyndon's farm raid as they portray in the series, but he did exist, and his sons did make the great heathen army, so we do know he was there. But what this does is it takes all 300 years of these Viking raids and condenses them into like 1.5 lifetimes of Ragnar's life and his sons. And especially in this last season, they have veered off the grid completely. But it's still entertaining as all hell. And it will introduce you to these people and give you some history. Element, I'll tell you right off the bat, they didn't dress like that. The way they portray him as being dressed? No. The way they battled? No, that you see better versions of that in The Last Kingdom. Their boats? No, you'll see better versions in Last Kingdom. The way they interacted? But again, it is direct. It's just like The Tudors, which is another series I'm going to recommend in a couple of days. It does a great job at introducing you to these people and getting you interested in them, so then you might take the time to go look them up and study their history and see what happened with them. As a historian, I kind of just go, oh, come on, no. And it's like, ah, no. But yeah, I mean, many of the characters are based on real, literally real people from history. Like the character of Athelstan. Athelstan was actually, if I remember right, grandson of King Alfred, which is like, wait, okay, so did they just take that name and use it for that monk? I don't know, but it's just like, okay, whatever. And then the attack on Lindon's farm happens in 793. Before the real Rollo was born, yet Rollo was on this. So it's just, that's what I'm saying, is they take a lot of history and make it entertaining, which I do not have a problem with. It's just every once in a while, it's like, no. Because, I mean, as Michael Herr said, I especially had to take liberties with Vikings because no one knows for sure what happened in the Dark Ages. And we want people to watch it. And it's like, yeah. So, that's the thing. I'm sitting here, I'm trying to think of, like, I know the Siege of Paris the Siege of Paris, and then when they come back and they raid Paris, and there's a whole scene with Ragnar dead in a coffin. That was pulled off by a different Scandinavian. That's what I'm just saying. They've taken real facts of history and incorporated it into the story of these people. And it's like, if you watch the series, please go look this stuff up. There are numerous people out there that have done in-depth historical inaccuracies of the show Vikings. And I will be doing one myself, too. And I'll probably go season by season and just say, hey, this is what actually happened during this and whatever. It's just... But again, it is such a good and engaging series. You are going to fall in love with the characters. You're going to fall in love with Agatha. You're going to fall in love with Ragnar. You're going to fall in love with Rollo. You're going to fall in love with Bjorn. It's just... And you're going to want to smack Ragnar a couple of times. It is that engaging. And that's why I highly, highly recommend watching it. And I recommend watching them both. You know, if you're going to watch Vikings, now then turn around. If you watch Vikings first, watch The Last Kingdom. Just so you can see what actually really happened. If you watch Last Kingdom first, hey, then watch Vikings. It's a fun ride. You'll enjoy the hell out of it. I mean, I know I do. I enjoy the hell out of it. And I'm a heathen myself. I honor the same gods. And it's just like, but it's a show. And they're trying to get it out to millions of people and make it enjoyable to millions of people, so they have to make it entertaining, and that's acceptable. So yeah, you got these two shows that are absolutely thoroughly entertaining. I mean, right there, you got Ragnar and Lagatha. Yeah, they're the heart and soul of the series, so you'll enjoy the hell of it. If you don't want to know what happens to these characters, don't read up about them first. Watch the show, because they do more or less follow the trajectory of these real people. So yeah, it's an enjoyable series. But again, historically inaccurate. If you want to know the truth and understand some of the stuff, go watch some of the other YouTube channels. Go look up some of the stuff on the internet, because none of us are still out right now. Don't know libraries are open, so you can't go study any of that stuff. But there's more than enough stuff out there that you can find. But there you go. Some stuff to watch for the next couple of days. I will be coming in another couple of days with some more videos of other stuff to watch. So I will see you guys next time. And go watch The Last Kingdom and go watch Vikings and enjoy them and let me know what you think. And I will see you next time. And hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell, and comment whether or not you did watch these.